much, colleague, Madam Minister Leonore Gewessler, dear Director General, ladies and gentlemen, dear participants. Well, it's really a pleasure for me welcoming you all today in a virtual way, only, unfortunately, but at least in this way, to Vienna, to the 19th ESDN workshop. And I think it comes at the right time. It is really important to debate all these things, and you do have important debates ahead of you for the next 2 days, including all the important stakeholders from parliamentarians, non-governmentals, representatives of the civil society, and so on and so forth. Parliament's involvement in the implementation of SDG is crucial, and therefore I would like to thank President Wolfgang Sobotka, who can't unfortunately be here with us, and thank also Director General Harald Dossi for organizing all this, for your contribution in the implementation of the SDGs. While my dear colleague, Leonore Gewessler, was already mentioning a lot of very concrete measures which we need to impose in the next years, I would like to have a look on where do we stand. COVID-19 has more and even more intensively shown us the importance of resilience and sustainability. Multilateralism, including EU efforts, is the necessary course of action. The pandemic highlights that we are all in the same boat. SDGs agreed by 193 UN member states are currently challenging all of us, and it shows the necessity to accelerate innovative and joint actions. 17 SDGs contain very strong potential for increased competitiveness and innovation, for example, fostering structural reforms. SDGs are a compass for decision makers, setting out issues viable for the future of our societies and for our planet. Last July, I had the honor to present Austria's first voluntary national review, and I would like to show it because we are really so proud on that. I could only present it in a virtual way in New York, the United Nations seat, and now it's the time to start doing concrete actions, as my dear colleague already mentioned. It's a starting point. We have to stick together, we have to strengthen our forces. We did not only put the focus on the status of implementation, but also on the inspiring success stories to show best practices and to have ideas for all of us how we can contribute to fulfill and implement the SDGs. The whole report is put under three main topics. The first, digitalization, and that was already the case before the pandemic took place. Secondly, fight against climate change. And thirdly, women, youth, and leaving no one behind. We are committed to learn, to improve, and to implement. The process of bringing together around 40 different institutions and actors and the knowledge base we have created with it is something that we build upon. What will we do? It is out of question that we have to accelerate the actions to be taken at all levels, at the European level. At the European level for implementing the Green Deal, to fill it with life. A very important role will also play the Conference on the Future of Europe when it comes to the discussion with the citizens of Europe, when we want to take their wishes, their concerns, but also their hopes with all the challenges we are seeing ahead. We will have the first plenary in Strasbourg this week on Saturday, and this is also very important to discuss all the topics, to structure the conference, and to have the best outcome in the end. Secondly, we have to go on the national level. We need to implement useful structural and procedural measures. Thirdly, we need, of course, the parliamentarian level, and I'm very proud that the Austrian Parliament has started this process already a few weeks ago, and that there is a four-party decision which aims to developing a mechanism to better involve the Parliament in SDG implementation. Then, of course, there's the regional and the local level, and we have inspiring projects and are therefore getting closest to the citizens. It is crucial, of course, to work together with NGOs because they are the backbone when it comes to the implementation of the SDGs. It is a whole of society approach, and we need all of you. And last but not least, we need, of course, science and research. It is the basis for evidence-based decision-making. Important is also that we collectively benefit from the synergies. And that's why we want to have this discussion, and that's why it is so important to have this workshop and others these days here in Vienna, in this way, and I hope in the future also in a physical way. Of course, learning from each other is important for our further implementation process, and we can get this out of this process. That is why today's exchange is only a starting point, why I wish you fruitful discussions, why I wish you and me, for us, really good results of this discussion, and I hope that we can see you once in Vienna and discuss how we did it. 2030 is not very far in the future, and we have to strengthen our forces now. Start on, and that's why I wish you all the best for these discussions. Thank you so much.